in order to figure out the maximum weight of the bucket that the wire system can support so that no single wire develops a tension exceeding 100 pounds, we can solve this problem by identifying the tension in each one of these wires with relation to the weight of the bucket. So to start, let's look at joint E where the bucket is attached. We will develop our free body diagram for that specific joint by placing the origin at the joint itself. Next, the weight of the bucket is acting vertically downward given by the variable W. Whereas I have a wire going from joint E to D, making an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. And finally, we have a wire going from E to B whose direction is given by a right angle triangle with the base of 3, perpendicular distance of 4, and the hypotenuse of 5. Once we have these free body diagram, then we can go ahead and apply our equilibrium equations of summation of all the forces acting along the horizontal x-axis equals to 0. So here we have our FED that is making a 30 degree from the horizontal. The x component of it can be calculated by taking the cos 30 function. Since it is directed towards the positive x-axis, that's why it's taken as positive. Whereas the force component of FEB that is directed towards the negative x-axis can be calculated by multiplying that force with 3 over 5. One other way to remember is that since 3 is parallel to the x-axis on that right angle triangle, that's why we have it in the numerator divided with the hypotenuse. That will give us its x component. Since these are the only two components present along the horizontal axis, their sum is equal to 0. Simplifying, we can get a value of FED in terms of FEB that is coming as 0.693 FEB. Let's mark that as our equation 1. Next, we can go ahead and apply our summation of forces in the vertical y direction equals to 0, taking upward as positive. Since the weight of the bucket is acting vertically downward, we will have a negative W in the equation. Next, I have a component of force FED. Again, since it is making a 30 degree from the horizontal axis, projecting this force on the vertical Y axis, we have to use the sine function. And since it is going upward, that's why it's taken as positive. And finally, we have a component of force FEB. Now, again, in order to get the vertical component, we have to look at the dimension that is parallel to the vertical axis. In this case, it is 4. That's why in the numerator, we have 4 divided by the hypotenuse, 5 times the force. That will give us the vertical component. Once we have all of them, we can add them up together and equate it equals to 0 because of the equilibrium condition. Simplifying, we can get the value of FED in terms of the weight, which is coming as 0.872 W. Now, once we have this force component, we can now plug that thing back in equation 1 and calculate the value of force in wire ED in terms of the weight as well. So to do that, let's plug in the value of FEB of 0.872 W in equation 1 and simplify that. This gives us the value of FED as 0.604 W. Now, once we have both of these wires in terms of the weight, we can see that one of them will experience much higher tension as compared to the other one because what's the number being multiplied with the W. So we still have to figure out two more wires, and once we have all of them, we can compare each 4 of those and see which one will experience the highest amount of tension, and that will be our deciding wire or the controlling wire here. Next, let's go ahead and draw the free body diagram of joint B by placing the origin on that particular joint. Here, three wires are again connected to joint B, starting with from B to E. We have already calculated the force developed in this wire given as 0.872 times the weight of the bucket. Next, I have a wire going from B to A. It's going in the horizontal negative x direction given by FAB. And then we have a wire going from B to C making an angle of 30 degrees from the horizontal. Once we have listed down all our loads on the free body diagram, we can go ahead and apply our equilibrium condition. So here, let's just start with summation of forces acting along the y-axis, taking upward as positive. Here, FBC, since it is projected along the y-axis, is being multiplied with the sine 30 component. Next, I have a component of my force 0.872W, and calculating that vertical component, I have to multiply it with 4 over 5. Since it is going in the downward direction, it is taken as negative. Now, we have only two force components going in the vertical direction, so their sum is equals to 0. Simplifying, we can get the value of FBC in terms of the weight of the bucket as well. That is coming as 1.396W. Now, once we have the force in wire BC, let's go ahead and write our summation of forces along the horizontal direction equals to 0. Now, on our free body diagram, we can see that the force FAB is going towards the negative x direction. That's why it is taken as a negative, whereas a component of our 0.872 weight is in the positive x-axis by multiplying it with 3 over 5 to calculate the horizontal component. And finally, I have my force FBC. The horizontal component of it can be calculated by multiplying it with cos 30. Since it is in the positive x-direction, that's why we have sine plus in our equation. Sum of all three will be equals to 0. Now, simplifying this particular equation gives us the value of FAB as 1.732W. Once we have identified the tension in each one of these cables with respect to the weight of the bucket, we have to identify which one of these wires will be experiencing the highest amount of tension. By looking at the four numbers, we can see that FAB will be the biggest number in this case. So, since we don't want that tension to exceed greater than 100 pounds, let's place the value of FAB as 100 pounds and solve for the weight of the bucket. So simplifying this expression, weight can be given as 100 divided by 1.732. That is coming as 57.7 pounds. This will be the highest weight of the bucket, so that each one of these wires are experiencing tension at max equals to 100 pounds.